ready?
All right, so here we go. The weight and the hype gives way to the action right here on one side. Maybe the division's most well-rounded fighter, taking on arguably the biggest submission threat in this division.
Because he's such a great submission grappler, I believe that this is the most dangerous fight for him in the division.
Wow.
He needs to maintain his pace, stay away from this guy at all costs, and force him to stand up for him.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman. Oh, big punch lands.
Oh, and he got tagged by that combination. His coach said on Thursday to us, it has to be punches and bunches. It has to be volume. And his student has certainly followed up on that imperative.
So much volume, but the accuracy of this fighter is truly unbelievable.
Now he's got the Muay Thai plug. Just misses with a left hook there. All right, he engages in a single collar tie here. Ooh, now he's got the tie plum, Daniel. If you're on the other side, what are you trying to do to get out of this potentially dangerous position?
You gotta start digging your shoulder to a side and then trying to shove an underhook. Oh, man, look at that. Picture perfect. Oh, he's attacking choke now.
Trying to pass here, but Dikembe Mutombo style,
blocked.
He gets denied.
Blocked! Great job blocking that pass by the bottom fighter.
Close guard. And he landed the right hand there. All right, well, he's got him softened up here. All right, we'll see how he chooses to defend here. Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice. Oh, on that punch right there. His opponent's compromised, DC.
It's one thing to land a hard shot. It's another thing completely to land a perfect shot. That was a perfect shot.
Oh, collar tie.
That's a big strike right there. You gotta check these low leg kicks.
Punch to the body looked pretty good, but ultimately it gets blocked by the defense. Nice job there. Oh, tags him with the jab on the counter. All right, he closes the distance, gets the single collar tie. And now he's got the tie clinch.
Big punch lands through the middle.
He's going after the head. All right, so he lands a jab there. Pretty nicely done, DC.
You get rid-
and an immediate transition to the judo throw right into side control.
He's in side control. He's got a ton of options.
Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here. All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. All right, this position now, what we call the north-south. If you're the bottom fighter, what are you trying to do to get out of harm's way?
Man, it's tough on the bottom. It's very tough because everything hurts, right?
Right.
It doesn't matter that they're not completely driving the shoulder in. It just, everything hurts. So you wait for your opponent to go to his next action. And when he does, you go and attack the hands. You get to your knees and you attack the hands with both hands and try to peel the lock so you can get to your feet.
He's got a serious right punch, and he went to it effectively there.
It is his money shot, and he will continue to throw it until he finds a knockout.
35 total strikes have now landed for Davison Figueiredo.
Big body kick. Big punch lands.
Nice hook lands. Throwing hard in the pocket.
Every time these guys come together, man, you just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very powerful, very, very explosive. He changes the angle, finds the right spot to land that punch to the head.
It tosses him down. Now we'll see if he can advance position.
I mean, right into side control.
All right, dominant position here. He's got the full mount. A lot of different ways he can go here. Maybe try to find an arm bar or just get the ground and pound.
He can attack submission, but those submissions...
Oh, and there's the horn at the end of the round. So the fighter was really caught in a submission there just as the horn sounded. Safe to say he was saved by the bell there. So back to the stools they go. 60 seconds to recover here. We're going to fight on, ladies and gentlemen. Another round coming up. All right, let's look back at some of the action in that round, DC. What a high-level display of offensive wrestling.
I mean, this is a joy for me to watch. I enjoy watching a guy maintain this level of wrestling for as long as he has done this. He is constantly in his opponent's face. He's constantly taking them down. Getting taken down and getting up is exhausting. Let's see how tired his opponent is at the start of the next round. Opponent has you in the clinch, pulling down on your head, landing punch after punch. You have got to clear that collar tie, reach back inside, and try to find space. Nice straight punch.
Moreno's punch to the body there doesn't get there. Nice job by the defense to block the shot. Oh, as good a counter striker as there is in the game. Straight right is good.
Game of inches right there, boy. Wow. It was a good night if that landed.
And now he's got that tight punch.
That one snuck in. Nice strike. He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots. Wow, what a kick!
His opponent's got him in the clinch. He needs to break away and get back to his range because he's taking punch after punch from his clinch position. Ooh, what a punch.
All right, he engages in the single collar tie. Lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Nice 1-2 there. Trying to find a home for that right hand.
He's back in the clinch position. This is where he has done a ton of good work here. Punch, punch, punch to the head from the clinch.
So a much different approach for him here in this second round. He was a little bit tentative in round one, a little bit of a feeling out process. Now he has clearly found his rhythm, found the range. We'll see if he can continue with more activity here in round two.
Beautiful punch.
Stuffs the takedown, no problem. Oh, that's a good right hand. Stuffs the takedown, no problem. Battling for hooks. Ooh, blocks the shot. Both guys really throwing with authority. Nice 1-2 there. Man, he's timing his shots nicely. It's like Tom Brady out there. He hasn't missed the target.
I mean, you insist on bringing in Tom Brady. Stop it. John, stop it. Good punch, Lance.
Oh, man, I'm starting to feel bad for the canvas as he lands another takedown there.
He got his foot on the hip, and now he's throwing up a triangle attempt. He's going to try to move his left arm across to get pressure on the choke. Oh, wow. Oh! Now he falls back into the finishing position.
Not tapping out tonight. All right, right into side control here, DC. Biggest difference between half guard and side control.
Well, side control to me feels like a little bit less control because now my legs aren't really doing anything anymore. Now I'm controlling you with my upper body. So I've got to be very, very aware. It's still advantageous, but it just seems a little more free-flowing than having something like a half guard.
All right, he's got side control here, DC. You know he's got a lot of different submissions in his arsenal once this fight gets to the ground. Oh, His opponent squirming like a fish out of water now. The ground and pound is on point. This could very well be the beginning of the end.
This could be the beginning of the end. We've seen some really good ground and pound fighters. This young man is as good as any we've ever seen.
Well, he's staying pretty effective here, fighting off of his back. Nice strike landed there by the bottom by Brandon Moreno. Oh, that'll work. The ground and pound strike is good.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here, and he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
Well, you know, I don't like the gi very much, but I have an appreciation and a healthy one for these type of transitions.
You can tell he's been in a gi at some point in his life with the way that he moves so freely.
I'm skipping jiu-jitsu next week, too. We now take a look back at some of the highlights from that last round, DC. A lot for the replay guys to choose from.
I mean, these guys are going to be very busy trying to find what replay to show you guys. Lands on both sides of the octagon. Both guys fought great. What a phenomenal round.
All right, next round is underway, DC. We talked about his powerful kicks, how he attacks all sides of the body, the head, the legs. Pretty good start for him tonight.
That was so impressive to see. Someone fight almost predominantly with their legs and have that level of success.
Well, not only has he stayed aggressive as he was in the previous round, landing a high volume of strikes, but he's also been efficient, not just with his strikes, but also with his body movement. Complete performance out of this fighter here tonight. Not there. Oh, an educated jab there. I could watch this dude jab all day.
I mean, he's so light on his feet, and when he pops that jab, it comes right back to his face.
Oh, and there's the double leg takedown for him. Beautiful entry there. All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
All right, has the guard closed here. Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent. You gotta be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. Oh, nice job to reverse position on the ground.
It was bad, but now it's not so bad. What a fantastic sweep.
Oh, looks like he's transitioning to an armbar.
You cannot stay in the guard of these great jiu-jitsu guys. Attack an armbar.
Has been isolated, but he picks him up and slams him down.
He lifted him through the air, slammed him on his back, and moves right into side control to get out of danger.
Beautiful job to not just turn defense into offense, but also to end up in a dominant position. Man, this is some serious ground and pound here, DC. He's not just staying busy for the sake of staying busy. These strikes are doing damage.
Oh, yeah, no pity pass to this guy. This guy's trying to land, and he's trying to land effective strikes.
All right, side control now, DC. You know he's in his element on the ground. A lot of tricks up his sleeve.
A lot of tricks.
Well, really nice work to keep busy off of his back as he lands some more offense here from Buff. Closed guard here. He's very comfortable here working off of his back, DC. Both fighters get up now.
Left hand punch from the clinch.
Muay Thai plump. Going to the body now with the kick. That one is blocked, though, by Brandon Moreno. Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there.
Nice strike.
Well, he works his leg. Now his opponent's really on the ropes.
His opponent's on beat street. He's hurt so bad. I don't know what he's going to do to stay in this fight.
Nice liver shot lands.
At the angle of that nice body kick.
Checks that leg kick. Well, not sure if he's lighter on his feet or what it is, but these last couple of rounds, he's been far more aggressive, a lot more pressure. Oh, he's really starting to light him up now.
shows. Liver kick.
Oh, is he a good counter striker? Counters beautifully with the left hand. Right single collar tie now. Boom. Man, he's just got a great feel for the striking realm early in this one.
The timing is on point. He's doing a great job of mixing everything up.
Well, if you like Muay Thai striking, this might be your moment in this fight as he gets the tie clinch.
This is a massive moment for this fighter. He is a great Muay Thai fighter. Look for him to go knee-knee and then try to land a big one to the head.
Straight right hand now just misses. Oh, and he connects with a punch there, DC. You gotta like what you're seeing, Muscle.
I mean, the speed at which he throws is crazy.
Oh, lands another shot to the body, beautifully placed as he continues to punish his opponent's midsection here in this round. Takedown attempt late, and it's good.
Oh, nice.
Oh, look at this. Jumps over on the side now to try to counter the guillotine. Maybe going with that Von Flue choke. I guess we should call him. Oh, and there's the horn at the end of the round. How about this fight, folks? You see, he was nearly caught in a submission there right at the end of the round, saved by the bell. So back to the stool, mentally probably not in a great place here. We'll see if he can recover and get himself back into this fight. All right, so a big round for him there, DC. We'll go back and look at some of the highlights. Big knockdown for him. We'll see if he can follow it up.
You could see that he was flowing. Everything was working in accordance to what he wanted it to be. And at the moment that it showed itself, the moment that the opportunity arrived, he jumped on it, got that big knockdown, and now he finds himself ahead in this fight.
All right, next round is now underway. I thought there was pretty good back and forth action in the previous frame.
Yes, it wasn't a bar fight. It wasn't two guys throwing the kitchen sink at each other. But you did see times when they came together and you saw the skill level of these two fighters.
Moreno's lower jaw looking extremely swollen now. All right, some good ground and pound by him here. Certainly staying busy, and not just busy, but effective.
You can just throw punches to keep the referee off you. This guy is throwing punches to be effective, to throw damaging strikes. He's doing a fantastic job.
Oh, wow, that happened quickly.
Now the guy's got armbar. He's attacking it on you. Gotta be careful, armbar.
Oh, he picks him up and slams him down.
Big explosive slam to lift him and slam him out of that armbar. Go right into side control. Now let's see what he does, right?
Sometimes when you do that, the choke or the submission can get tighter, but he was able to evade it there.
Yes.
Back to the feet now. Oh, that right hand is on point. Effective punch there by Brandon Moreno. Single collar tie now. Big power shot there. Oh, found the target there with a straight right counter. Well, he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. He continues to connect on a high volume of strikes here. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active.
Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick.
Lands a big elbow there.
He's grabbing the back of the head, pulling forward on the head, and then landing those beautiful punches. Really got his opponent on those.
Ooh, he landed a huge hook there. Oh, straight right.
Nice.
Man! Stuffs that takedown attempt without issue. Nice defense there. Huge block. Got the single collar tie.
Beautiful strike.
Oh, continuing to work the body to great effect.
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh, he might right to it. Oh! His hand still attached to his body.
It was overly aggressive. They got him. And you know, they still have a problem. Alex Perkins' head. Oh, he might have got him with a choke.
Wow! Go, guys, one. Well, you got to stay busy on the bottom. He's doing it here. Nice punch. All right, he's got the full mount now. Is this one of the most dominant positions in MMA? Is that fair to say?
It's a very dominant position. It's one of the most ideal positions you can get to, especially if you are fighting someone that doesn't truly understand that they're not in as much danger as they are, because it's dangerous, but there are a lot of outs. And if a person isn't very understanding of that, then you can really, really put some damage.
Oh, it looks like he's going for an armbar here. How tight is that?
You gotta recognize that when a guy starts to put his feet on your hips, you gotta move him off, and you gotta cover. You can't be off to an angle. It's in there deep. There you go.
The sheer will is really remarkable to watch. Side control now, and certainly I would think more offensive options for the bottom fighter than in the half guard.
Absolutely more offensive options, because now you can just start to get away. You can just go to a wrestler stand-up. Get to your knees, post your hands, don't allow him to get his hooks in, right? Really be able
to... Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom. The Kimura is not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
And now, and there's the horn at the end of the round. So the fighter was really caught in a submission there just as the horn sounded. Safe to say he was saved by the bell there. So back to the stools they go. 60 seconds to recover here. We're going to fight on, ladies and gentlemen. Another round coming up. All right, let's check out some of the action, DC. And how about the punching acumen by that fighter in that previous round?
He does not waste anything. He does not loop punches. Everything's tight. Everything's precise. He's a sniper. We always talk about how he's a sniper. He is a sniper. And it showed in that exchange that allowed him to drop his opponent.
You ready? You ready?
Fifth and final round, fourth cup.
I mean, he's cutting down the size with these beautiful leg kicks.
How about that?
And his opponent seems to be on his way out of the fight.
That was a jab! Oh, nice right hand!
Oh, straight right!
Nice, sneaky head kick.
Back to the leg kick now. That one's no good. Just misses with that one. And they separate.
Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick.
Man, it doesn't take much for the redness to start. Look at the left side of his body there. Nasty. And he gets the takedown.
He gets the takedown and falls right in the side. Oh, you gotta watch him attack his submissions. He throws the legs up to try to get a triangle choke here. Oh! Now he falls back into the finishing position.
Somehow stays in the fight. All right, side control now, DC. When you get side control in a fight, what are you looking for?
When I get to the side control in the fight, and I believe this young man should do the same thing, it's secure first. Grab everything in tight. Make sure your elbows are in. Make sure you've got something locked in so your opponent doesn't just squirm away. Punch short punches, but try to make the opponent make a choice. Either he turns back into you, you take your front headlock, or he turns in the opposite direction, you throw your hook in, and you start looking to get a choke off.
Well, Well, not ideal to spend this much time on the bottom, but you can't fault him for his activity. Landing strikes here from the bottom. Nice work by the assassin baby, Brandon Moreno. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Love watching this guy move on the ground. Another nice transition there.
Such a high-level grappler. You don't see that very often.
Well, he's more than content to work off of his back, DC, where he has been a magician in his UFC career. A lot of top pressure being applied here. All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Under 2 minutes now to go in the fight. All right, he's hanging out inside the closed guard of his opponent here, DC. You got to be careful. All right, trying to pass here. As Glover Teixeira might say, not today.
Not today. Great job of following with the hips, keeping those legs locked and keeping them in full guard.
Moreno's got the full mount. Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound starts.
Looks like he's got a couple hooks in here, DC, and defensively, you better be careful. Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. Moreno's looking to pass out of the half guard here, maybe looking for side control. He's denied. Oh, reversal here, DC.
What a way to switch the position. Fantastic movement by the bottom fighter.
Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. All right, working inside the closed guard now. This is no safe place against this opponent. 45 seconds remain in the round. All right, he's got the hooks in, DC, working off of his back.
Now look for him to attack the neck of his opponent to try to get the rear choke.
All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Keeping busy here off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom.
Now he's going to try to attack Kimura here. Oh, now he's in trouble.
Brilliant submission defense there. All right, so the title fight goes the distance. I don't want to steal Bruce Buffer's thunder because he doesn't like that, but and new UFC champion of the world you're looking at.
Yeah, he's the new champ. No matter how you want to look at it, he did enough to take the belt off the champion. He used his striking, his footwork, his beautiful movement in order to confuse the champion over the course of 5 rounds. He did enough. It's time to strap the belt around his waist.
See how the judges saw it. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. All three judges score the contest.
48-47.
The winner by unanimous decision, and new undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Brandon the Assassin Baby.
See, we got a new UFC flyweight champion tonight, DC. We knew it was going to take a big effort to dethrone the champion. He gets it done.
I mean, the excitement that you showed was shared by the entire arena by this great performance. No one thought that he could get the job done. Tonight, he shocks the masses and becomes a UFC champion.